YouTube. What's up, baby? We're back in this thing again with another review. This is Q's Insight. I am Callie. And today, we're going to be talking about Black Friday. This is a horror comedy that came out in 2021. And when I saw the trailer, I was, you know, a little intrigued just because of the fact that it had, like, Bruce Campbell in it and Michael Jai White. So I, you know, wanted to check it out. And I ended up waiting a little bit. But I would not, like, look at any of the spoilers for the movie. And so I just saw it on Vudu, and I was just like, yo, let me just grab it real quick. So I grabbed it, and it was, like, for, I think, $7.99. So why not? But anyways, yeah. You already know how we do it when it comes to this channel. If you've been here before, started off with the premise, three favorite scenes, the grade, and then we're on to the next one. Black Friday is basically a movie that kind of takes place, I'll explain the story because the story is kind of a character as well. I mean, not like anything crazy, but I'm just saying, like, the store that they work at, it's similar to a Walmart. And then you have thus individuals that work at that so-called Walmart type store, right? And they all have a shift on Black Friday. And, you know, they end up going to work, dreading to go to work, you know, whatever it may be. But they go to work, and then things are not as simple as they thought it would be. Ends up being, like, in the beginning of the movie, there is a situation where a guy gets infected by this, like, worm-looking creature. And he ends up turning into, like, from that, he ends up turning to, like, what you would consider a zombie. Then, you know, that spreads around, and now multiple places are being hit up, you know, with waves of these virus-infected people, you know, basically looking like zombies. But this is, you know, your story of that store, you know what I'm saying, while it's going on, while that situation is going on. So, you know, certain characters in there, you follow them. We end up seeing that the zombies are, you know, attacking people within the store and around the store, but they're building something. And it's like, you know, what are they building? But all in all, pretty much a, like, it's an average zombie flick, you know what I'm saying? Simplistic story. But yeah, man, that's basically it. Just these people that work at this store that's equivalent to Walmart on Black Friday, they're working. An infection has spread it throughout the town. I don't know, the world or whatever, I don't know, but definitely that town. In that area, for sure. Zombies come attack the store. We also find out they're building something. And, you know, we're just trying to survive and get out of this, you know. That's basically the story. So, three of my favorite scenes from here would probably be, and this may be out of order, three of my favorite scenes would be when Michael Jai White was taken out some of the zombies, like, I mean, this is spoiler alert, whatever. When he's taking out the zombies, like, right before he gets taken out. You know, he just came in, you know, with the whole martial arts status and just taking out all the zombies, bro. And then, like, it's stupid because, like, literally, like, after he takes out, like, 3 or 4 zombies, like, right after that, he just ends up dying. But, yeah, so that's one of them. Second one would be... Well, second one would be, like, when they were all together in a break room, like, all the workers that were still alive, they were all together, and, you know, it's Thanksgiving or whatever it may be. So, the girl in there, the girl ends up checking the freezer and, or the fridge. Her name is Marnie. Her name is Marnie on there. She goes to check the fridge. And, you know, everybody's, like, just kind of having a, everybody's kind of just having, like, a rough time with everything that's going on. The zombies, the store, having to work already and, you know, not knowing if your family's okay, if you're going to be okay, whatever it may be. So, you know, it was nice for them to be able to get some little cheap little turkey, you know what I'm saying? They were slices. They all got a piece. They all just vibe together. You know, you don't know if this would be a last night living or whatever it may be. So, that was a cool scene. And then my third favorite scene is, okay, you find out what the zombies were doing, like, after, you know, they take over the store, they're, like, building something, right? So you find out what it is that they're building, and then you find out what they become themselves, and they become this one entity that's super tall, like Godzilla. That was stupid, but what was funny was when the black dude on there, he's like a manager or like an assistant manager or whatever. He's like, yo, to the people that are still alive, like, you know, his coworkers, he's like, yo, like, I got this, you know, I'll talk to him, you know, So he goes and talks to the bro, like, he's trying to, like, reason with this big old monster, bro, like, this big old Godzilla zombie, and at first, it kind of looks like the zombie is, like, hearing him, and is able to, like, understand, like, what he's saying, and it's like, okay, like, that's crazy, bro. The zombie, like, bends all the way down, like, picks up his hand, and just goes, bah, like, and then the black dude just, like, flies. That was funny, man. So anyways, those were like 3 of my favorite scenes. Man, this movie was okay. Like, it wasn't the best. I wasn't expecting it to be the best. I just thought it would be like a fun little flick to watch. You know, it had you know, Bruce Campbell, and it has Tony Jaa White, and it has I'm sorry. it has Bruce Campbell. It has I think it's Devin Sawa, or the dude that was in Final Destination 1. Like the main character on there with the blonde hair. It's crazy to see him. Like, I wanted to see how he looked, you know, after so many years. Like, and then I said Michael Jaa White, you know, so it was It was cool. It was worth the watch. Should they make a sequel? Probably not. But, you know, this was cool. It was good for what it was. I enjoyed my time. Just turn off your brain, watch the flick, you know, enjoy it if you can. Try not to criticize it so hard, or be so rough on or with the critiquing, because it's just, you know, this is like a simple movie. So yeah, it was cool. I enjoyed myself. I think I would give it a, I give it a 7 out of 10, 7 out of 10. So better than average, you know, and, I think most people will have a, you know, cool little time watching it. It's a different movie, but it was good at the same time. So yeah, bro, that's it. Gave you the premise, three favorite scenes, my grade, which is 7 out of 10. If you guys saw the movie, let me know what you guys thought about it. What were some of you guys' favorite scenes? Do you wish that they had did things differently? Would you like to see a sequel to this? But yeah, just let me know about that in the comments down below. As always, please like, subscribe, and share. This is Q's Insight. I am Callie. Until next time.